Hey folks, I'm Rob. Welcome back to vidIQ. Very recently, I told all of you that subscribers are dead. And then YouTube released a new live subscriber count page. I'm clearly being trolled. Let's have a little fun with this one. Here's our real-time subscriber count with a clock underneath. However long it takes to edit this video is how many subscribers we got in the time it took to make this video. Pause this video, have a guess how many think we're gonna get, and I'll show you how to get this page for yourself. In the YouTube studio on the dashboard, you will already see your exact subscriber count, but it's not live. So go to analytics, and on the real time panel on the right hand side, you will see your subscriber count. This is in real time, but it's not very fancy. So YouTube have decided to create a dedicated page. So I hope YouTube have rolled this out to everybody all at once so nobody complains that they can't see it yet. It's pretty basic, as you can see, but this number will tick forward or indeed backwards depending on who is doing what with that subscribe button. Below that, you have a subscriber graph, which you can minimize if you wish, but it does have a time period selector on it, which is pretty cool, especially if you set it to lifetime. Have a guess when I started making videos for vidIQ. It's cool that this does basically allow you to see exactly how many subscribers you had at any point in your channel's history. But what I'm most disappointed in right now is the fact that nobody's actually subscribed to this while I've been demoing the screen. There you go. Now, to be clear, this does not mean a return to accurate public subscriber counts. They will remain abbreviated and can sometimes be a little behind the studio subscriber count. What this does allow creators to do is potentially live stream their own live subscriber count once again through something like OBS or Streamlabs, which is what we'll probably do when we get close to a million subscribers. Oh, come on, who's just unsubscribed?
Okay, I've got a bit of a sit rep here. I need to take Jasper for a walk because he's desperate to do his business. So it's going to extend the editing time a little bit and it gives me a chance to get some more subscribers. You ready? Let's do this. All right, you've got 3 seconds to screenshot this and turn it into a meme. I'm trying to get Jasper's attention, but he's distracted by a dog.
Yep, he loves artificial grass.
And we are done. How do we do? Oh, thanks for all the subscribers. Yeah, Jasper says thanks. Back to work.
Now, I've had a couple of ideas about how vidIQ could improve this page. One thing is that we could add a milestone predictor that calculates your next big subscriber number. And another was to add the previous subscriber milestone achievement certificate from vidIQ on the right-hand side where you could share it on social. Of course, all of this and more is already available from the Achievements vidIQ tool. But yeah, if you want us to add it to the real-time subscriber page, I need as many as you as possible to tell us so in the comments so I can convince our developers. Okay, so we're having some fun here with a new YouTube real-time subscriber page. But why did I say at the beginning of this video that I think subscribers are dead? Well, what I mean by that is that YouTube subscribers have never been a reliable piece of data in terms of assessing a channel's health or its potential to grow in the future. YouTube have recently released a new data set called Return Viewers, which is much more reliable in tracking the progress of your channel and how it may grow in the future. It all boils down to building an audience as opposed to beating an algorithm and getting more YouTube subscribers. I have now made a trilogy of videos on this topic, all in a separate playlist. Do make sure to check it out if you have time. Now then, yes, it looks like we've passed 826,000 subscribers on the channel. Thank you very much. I'm going to now see when it happens on this clock. Any second now. not going to happen, is it?